Hello again and welcome back to our course on Word 2013. We're now going to take our first look at Word, and the first thing you need to do, of course, is to start it. Now, I'm not going to spend a lot of time explaining the options here. I'll just quickly go through them. I'm running this course using a Windows 8 PC, and I have put a shortcut to Word in the middle of the desktop here, and anytime I want to start Word, I'm going to double click on that with my mouse. If you're using Windows 8 and you have Word 2013 installed, it should appear as one of the tiles on your start screen, and you could tap or click on that. And if you're running Windows 7, Word 2013, once it's installed, will appear on your start menu, probably in the Office 2013 group on the start menu. I suggest that you give yourself a convenient and quick way of starting Word each time. Again, in Windows 8, I've got a shortcut for Word 2013 on my taskbar, and I just click that anytime I want to start Word 2013. Now, when Word 2013 opens for the first time, you should see a screen similar to this one. And this screen enables you to do what are perceived to be the things you are most likely to want to do when you open Word. Now, on the left, there is a list with a heading Recent that may be completely empty. In fact, if this is the first time you've used Word, it will be completely empty. If you've upgraded from an earlier version of Word, then you may well see a list of recently opened documents here instead. In this case, there are no recently opened documents, so the list is empty. But as we go ahead, we'll see file names start to appear here. And opening a recently opened copy of a document is something you'll do quite often with Word. So if I work on a particular document, say a letter to a business colleague, if I then close Word, go away, do something else, come back, I'll see that letter in the list of recents here. And that's a very convenient way of accessing documents that you've worked on recently. We'll come back to open other documents a little bit later on. In the top right hand corner of the display here is my username, and in this case details of the Microsoft account that I use in relation to Windows 8 on this device. And then in the middle we have the main area we're going to concentrate on at first. If you look at these thumbnails, that one has a caption blank document, that one has a caption Welcome to Word, and the others correspond to what are called templates. Now, we're going to look at templates in some detail later on, but let's assume that the first thing I want to do is to create a document in Word, which is what we're going to do in this section. And actually in this section we're going to start with a blank document. But as we'll see in a little while, if you wanted to start with a document where a lot of the layout, a lot of the style is already established for you, you can use one of the provided Word 2013 templates. Now, if you look at these thumbnails, you'll see that there's quite a reasonable list of these templates here. There are quite a few. There's some Christmas-related ones there, various ones celebrating different events and so on. But in fact, there are many, many more than this. And the section at the top enables us to search for online templates. So for instance, if I wanted a template to use for a fax, I could type fax in here and then do a search online for a fax-related template. But more of that later. Let's concentrate here on blank documents. So click on blank documents. What Word does is to create a blank document. So what we have here is the Word 2013 workspace. And the main feature of the workspace in many ways is the document itself. Now, the document we're working on, remember we asked for a blank document, is indeed a blank document. And within the blank document, there is a flashing cursor just here, vertical line. And the flashing cursor indicates where text would go if I started typing. So I'm just going to type on my keyboard, "Hello world." And that now becomes the content of my document. Think of this area as a big white sheet of paper. We've just typed "Hello world" onto that big white sheet of paper. Now, I appreciate that those of you who are using touch devices may be using an on-screen keyboard here. I'm going to come back to that later on. But basically, when you've opened and started this first document, whichever method you're using, just put some text in there. And you have now started work on your first Word document. Now, the document already has a name. Every document in Word will have a name. And by default, when you open a new document, it's called Document 1, and the name you can see at the top on what's called the title bar up here. So it says Document 1 Word. And if I wanted to give that a more meaningful name, I can do that in a moment. I'll come back to that in just a moment. Now, basically, what's going to happen is that when you work on a document, you're going to put words, text, tables. You may be reviewing somebody else's document. You may be putting all sorts of multimedia elements into this document. But when you've finished working on it, you will normally want to save a document. And you'll normally want to save it with a name that suits you or a name that you've been told to give it. And you'll need to save it somewhere that you can find it. So the next thing we're going to do is to take this first document and just save it. Now, many aspects of saving I'm going to explain in more detail a little bit later on, but let's just do a straightforward save at the moment. To save a document, we go into something called Backstage View. So we click on the File tab up here on the left. The dark blue in this case, depending on your color scheme, you may have a different color showing, but it'll normally be white text on a darker background, whereas the other things along here are dark text on a light background. Click on File, and that takes you into something called Backstage View. Now, within Backstage View, there are a number of commands on the left. I'll be spending a lot of time talking about these commands, but the only one we need at the moment is Save As. Now, you use Save As the first time that you're going to save a document, partly to save it and partly to give it the name that you want to give it. First of all, the question of where to save it. I could save it to my SkyDrive. So this is effectively saving it in the cloud, or Microsoft's version of saving it in the cloud. I could save it on my computer, or I could save it in another place. Now, I'm going to talk about other places later. I'm just going to go for my computer. And if I want to find where I want to save it, I can either use a folder that I've accessed recently, or I can browse. I'm going to click Browse on this occasion. And that gives me a pretty standard Windows-type browser. Now, I mentioned earlier on that you should have the example files that go with this course in a folder on your device. And I suggest that you don't save files like this one, these little sort of practice files, in the same folder. And I've set up a second folder just to use for these exercise files. And as we go through, you'll see that as I save these, you should have a pretty equivalent set in a similar folder. Now, the folder that I've got for the exercises, the practice files using as we go along, is on my desktop. So if I double click to desktop, it's got there, I've called it 80 exercise files. Double click on that, it's currently empty. So I'm going to put my files in there. And the first one, the file name, Word 2013 has given it a name, helloworld.docx. Until you choose a name yourself, Word 2013 will normally use the first piece of text in a document as the file name to use. Now, I'm going to stick with the name helloworld.docx here, so that's okay, and I just click on the Save button. My document is now saved, and if you look at the top of the title bar, you'll see now that what was just Document 1 now says helloworld.docx. DOCX at the end indicates that it is a Word document. In fact, it indicates that it is a Word document in a recent format, but more of that later on. So that's great. We've made our first document, saved it. What we're going to do now is to close the document. Having saved it, it's still there. I could still do more work on it if I wanted to. But I'm going to leave it like that for now. And what I want to do is to close it, to stop working on it. So I go back into Backstage View using the File button. And then a little bit further down than Save As is a button that says Close. Click on Close. and the document is closed. And now in my Word workspace, I have nothing at all because I'm not working on a document anymore. So, having finished working on that document, we may decide, well, that's it for now. I want to finish working with Word altogether. If you look to the right of the title bar, right at the top of the window there, there's a cross right at the end. And if I hover over that cross, you can see what's called its screen tip. It says close. And if I click on that, it will close Word. So, click on close, and Word is closed as well. So, in this section, we've opened Word, created a new document, put some text in it, saved it in a known location, closed that document, and closed Word. So that's a pretty good start. Join me in the next section about getting started to find out a little bit more about the Word workspace. I'll see you then.
Hi everyone, Simon here from Simon Says It. Thanks for watching this video. If this is your first time here, I'd love for you to subscribe. Every Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, new videos are uploaded to the Simon Says It channel here on YouTube. Just click on the subscribe button right over there. If you're interested in taking your Office 2013 training to the next level, you can get over 70 hours of Microsoft Office 2013 training offered by Simon Says It. Just check out the About section below this video with more details. We'll see you next week with additional videos.